bit messy. Oh, what the fuck? Oh, is it bad? And then here's the boss. My family debates every time we have dinner. See, I don't mind debates. And you know what? The reason I think I love debates, teetering onto arguments, is because like, I'm never wrong. I'm never wrong. Like, okay, well, here's the thing. I'm very selective into getting into arguments or debates because I will not willingly go into a debate if I don't know what I'm talking about. Maybe it's that I'm fucking stubborn. Maybe I'm just fucking stubborn. Who knows? But like, I am genuinely willing to bet that every argument I've ever gotten into, like 97% of them, I was right. I was right in 97% of them. I'm willing to fucking say like that ratio is not too high. This boss is fucking lit. Nah! Oh my god. But I think that's actually the issue with me and my girlfriend right now is that we're both fucking stubborn as hell. But like the difference is like I'm the one who's always right, not her. So like, you know, even though we're both stubborn, I'm stubborn and right. She's stubborn and wants to be right. Still love her, but like, I'm right. I'm right always. Well, not always, like 99.9% of the time. Literally lit, like literally fucking the embodiment of lit. I can't do it! This part I can do, I just need to fucking prep myself. Yes! We in there. What a willingness to learn there, Dion. Well, no, I'm just saying, I'm really rarely willing to get into arguments if I know I am in the wrong. You know what I mean? Like, people always used to tell me growing up, my parents, friends of parents, teachers, they always used to tell me I should become a lawyer because I'm so fucking good at arguing. Even in the albeit rare times that I am wrong, I can argue to the point where you'll think I'm right. Like, you'd be like, shit. Like, maybe. Like, cause I'm good with words. I can word things to the point where you're like, yeah, shit. Maybe he is right. I don't fucking know anymore. What's up, Rock Viper? How's it going, buddy? All right, that one wasn't that bad. Fucked up, I think. Am I supposed to? I think I'm supposed to bounce off those but not land on them? I think that's how that was supposed to be done. I think I'm supposed to keep one there. That's interesting. Yeah, I think I'm supposed to get close to these but not actually touch them because they're spiked. Oh, those are fucking poison. Tell me why 2 plus 2 equals 5. Tell me why that's right, P. Alright, so, listen. Numbers aren't even a fucking real, bro. Like, the numbers are just something that was made up by somebody. They're just like, this little symbol right there, that's gonna be 2. That symbol right there is gonna be 2. But what if it wasn't 2? Or what if it was 2? But what if 5 wasn't 5? What if 5 was actually technically what we know as 4? Numbers are just something that was made up by somebody to make sense of things. So like, I could make up my own language in which 2 plus 2 would equal 5. You know what I mean? In my language, in my own personal language, 2 plus 2 equals 5. This one's kind of tough. Nah, I thought I could cheese it. Messy stuff. Oh, that's so troll. That is so troll. That is the most trolly thing I've ever seen in my life. What up, Maddie? How's it going, bud? How long is this level? Thank God. And I guarantee you've all heard this before. Oh no, I talk about this all the time. How, like, how do you know your purple is the same as my purple? Like that type deal. Like, yeah. Like there's literally no way we can ever know. But then you realize that yes, there is a way. Because like, the scientists have like thoroughly studied the makeup of the human eye, so there is a way to tell that we all do perceive colors the same way. Except sans the fucking inclusion of people who are, say, colorblind. I keep doing that. I just need to walk off that second platform. Oh shit. But isn't that a bit of a mind fuck? I was gonna say that's literally a mind fuck. Like you can't, there is no way that you can think of a color that isn't possible to fucking, oh Jesus chat, you're gonna make my fucking head hurt. There's no way, there's no logical way you can think of any color that you can't possibly replicate from what we can see. Like, that is such a fucking mindfuck. But they're like Dylan said, like, shrimps have fucking 17 color receptors. They can see more colors than we can see, but we can't even fucking imagine those colors. Like, it's not possible. Also, fun fact, did you know that, so say you're having a dream, right? You're in a crowd of people, just all random people that you swear you've never met before. Every single face you see in your dream is a face you have seen sometime in your life. Whether it be somebody, say you were driving down the road and another car passed and you looked in the window and you saw somebody. Every single face you see in a dream is a face that you have seen at some point in your life because the human brain is incapable of just making up a face. The human brain is literally incapable of just thinking up of a random person's face. So like, if you were to just draw like a random person's face, that's somebody you've seen before. That is someone you have at one point in your life seen before. That's not true, Pete. That is true. You can eat my fucking dick, you bitch, Brian. See, Brian, this is why everybody fucking hates you. This is why everybody fucking despises you, Brian. You fucking suck me off, you fucking dickhead. I still love you though, kind of. Walk off it.
shit.
Oh, fuck. How long are these levels now? I can't. And there's no checkpoints, which is what makes it fucking worst. Thing ever!
Okay.
So if police investigators that draw criminals draw the victim what the victim has described, then that similar person in the drawing is a real person? Listen, I don't know. I don't make the rules here. I don't make the rules here. I'm not even smart. I just read what scientists do. And I'm like, hey, I know that now. I didn't figure it out, but I know it. By the way, I have onion rings upstairs. And you don't. But maybe you do. How do I know? You might have onion rings. Do you have onion rings upstairs, chat? Kappa 123 in chat if you have onion rings upstairs. Now everybody's in the Kappa 123 and I know you're all fucking liars. I invented onion rings. Nobody else has onion rings besides me. Because I invented them. It's not possible that you guys have them because I made them up. Onion rings aren't even real. Did you know it's not possible to eat onion rings because PBAT made up onion rings? It's literally not possible to make up onion rings because I invented onion rings just now. Every onion ring you've ever had in your life previous to this have not been onion rings. Gotcha. Go, close! Oh, I'm tired of you, you bitch. Oh, I see what they're doing. So things have to touch them and then they'll close. Oh, and they open back up, okay. So I think I need to rocket them. Oh, give me a fucking break with this. What? Oh, I fell through it? Broke ass game, dude. Broke ass game. Oh, I didn't even lose there. Yo, the skips! Yo, the skips! I don't even need to fuck with those things, bro. The skips! Let's go! What? Oh, I see. Oh, troll! Oh, I was so far! I got so far and tried so hard. And now my dick has officially fallen off. I had to fall to lose my dick. Oh, again? Hi, caramba, fucking mamma mia. Uh-oh, wait, nope, we're good. Be good. Are you more looking forward to the release of Ukulele or Hat in Time? Oh, Ukulele, that's not even a fucking question. Like, I'm really looking forward to Hat in Time, but like, Ukulele is a whole other fucking story, my man. Like, that's not even comparable, you know? Like, oh shit, this level's gonna be fucking hard. What the fuck? Like, yeah, that's I don't even think that's a comparison. I don't even think that's something to be compared. Oh shit. Ah. That one's kind of difficult. You have to time that right. Oh, I messed that up again. Is there going to be a special sub-event at 420? I mean, actually, yes, there is going to be. Yes. And it is going to be quite lit. Is that what you kids say these days? Lit? It's going to be lit. I made it.
We made it! We made it!
Do I even need to do that? Like, I feel like I can skip that. I can. Why the fuck was that even a thing? I can skip that too. Oh no, because you only get your fucking little jetpack booster if you land on the ground again. I really need to fucking hit that fucking... There we go. What? Oh, that's so difficult. Oh shit, I jumped the gun there. Bruh, I can't aim. Oh, right, I have no fucking boost. I went off the idea that I had a boost. So I can make that, I just need to get a little bit higher. I mean, I know I can, I made it before. Ah, fuck. I keep, still a year away? I mean, at least a year away. They still haven't announced like a release date, they just gave an estimate. Oh, there's a... That's pretty troll. And that's, I think, the only downside I'd say about this game so far. Is that there really isn't... Like, there needs to be a form of checkpoint. There needs to be a form of checkpoint because... Because of the fact that some levels are just too long and there's too many... Not pixel-perfect jumps, but, like... Kind of demanding. And I mean, I'm only on like the third world out of, what, 8? 9? What platform are you getting it for first? First. Why would I ever get it from multiple platforms? Oh my god, I just recovered. Oh, I could have made that. Shit. I mean, no hate on the team, but come on, it started in 2007. Well, yeah, but I mean, you have to remember, for example, let's take Mother 3, for example. I think Mother 3's production year, or production time, was, I believe, 3.5 years. And that was with a huge team of people. Whereas Mother 4 is a fan game where they don't dedicate all of their time. Basically, they're dedicating their free time to it because they're not being paid to do it. and it is a much smaller, I'm sure it's a much smaller team than the Mother 3 team was. You know what I mean? Granted, it's probably a little easier because technology has changed, technology has evolved, just making games is, you know, easier now. But that still doesn't change the fact that A, this is something they're doing in their free time, and B, the team is much, much smaller. And they don't want to rush it. I mean, I'm sure they could have had something done by now for you guys, but they don't want to rush it out. They want it to be an experience that people are genuinely going to enjoy. I know this because I know the Mother 4 team. I know Shane Mesa. I know a few of the other ones. They're working their asses off. And they have some good stuff in store for you guys. I'm actually probably going to be streaming Mother 4 before it's even released. Probably like a week or a few days before it's released. Going to be doing a live stream event for it. So, trust me, they got some... They have good stuff. They have good stuff. But ukulele, I mean, I technically am getting it on two consoles, but I'm only going to be playing it on one. It's just because I kickstarted it for, I don't remember how much. I think it was the one that gives you a physical and digital copy of the game. So technically I'll have it for two, I'll technically have two copies. But one is just for like the whole physical game collection thing that I have going on, so. Oh, my head touched it. My head just grazed it. Well, that's not true, Ash. That's not entirely true because there is such a thing called scope. I mean, when you're making a game, you're not always doing it to push boundaries. Of course, you want to innovate and do new things, like, you know, similar to what we're doing with the game, or a few of the games we're making now. Well, one of the games we're making now is mostly the innovative one. The other ones are, I'd say two of them are innovative. One of them is... playing it pretty safe. I'd say one of them is playing it pretty safe. Yeah, most of it's, They don't want that, Jack. It's already been discussed multiple times within the team. And I'm being very... Because I'm not part of the Mother 3 team, I just know people on the Mother 4 team, so... I don't want to say anything because I don't know like what they want to be like public knowledge and what they don't want. But there has been many people saying like, why don't you just let us donate so we can support it? They will not. They do not want to accept donations. I don't know why. That's their choice entirely. But I know they do not want to accept donations. I need more games like Undertale in my life? Well, see, that's a very broad statement. Like, what do you mean, like Undertale? Because that could mean so many things. That could mean a game, that could mean an RPG, like a old school styled RPG. That could mean a game with multiple endings. That could mean a game with a good story, lovable characters. Like saying a game like Undertale is like such a broad... If you were to go to a fucking, If you were to go to a chef and say, I want a burger like a McDonald's burger, that's like such a broad... That's too broad of a... That's such a broad statement. If you were to tell me you want a game like Undertale, I really wouldn't know what you mean. Games that I can enjoy fully, but that's still another really broad statement because what one person may enjoy fully may not be the same for somebody else. Some people are gonna wanna fucking play FIFA. I can't stand sports games, so like, made it. I can't stand sports games, so like, what, you know, what that would be for one person would not be for the other, you know? Alright, what's this shit? I think this is, we're gonna beat this boss and then that's gonna be it for today, guys. Well, not for like the whole stream, but for this game. It's a centipede! Steve, are you watching? House centipede, your favorite. shit. Okay, so I can't actually launch myself off. I can go up, I think. No, I can't. Actually, I can't. Those walls are fucked. Oh, that's a fucking death tile. Whoops. Ah, shit. I need to land on that fucking... I need to land on this dick again. And then go up. Ah, he spins me off of it. What a fucking troll. This is gonna be a little tough. Actually, hold on. Let me see if I can cheese something real quick. Nah, I can't cheese it. Actually, I can do that, though. Alright, let me try that. Yeah, that's a good way to fucking cheese it. Alright, so watch this. Ah, I fucked that up. Keep rushing it, I think. Oh, what a fucking troll. I need to, like, land on his tail there, I think. I'm actually not sure. There we go. Oh, there's a little bit of a fucking wall there. I didn't see that. Okay, that makes that a little bit easier. Well, not easier, but it makes more sense now. I can't make that. Am I supposed to be... Yeah, that's better. Yeah, I need to land on his tail there. Wow, this seems pretty difficult. I bought a shirt last second yesterday. Oh, okay, because I noticed we sold 90 shirts. And then after, like, 5 minutes after the timer expired, we were at 91. So I guess you were the last person. Thank you, Jaskobi, for buying that last second shirt, buddy. Very much appreciated. That might actually be easier there. I'm actually not sure. I was so close. I don't even know how far away from the end I am. That's why. Did somebody say the end? Did somebody say Minecraft? Oh shit, I can go up that way too instead? That's interesting. That might be actually a little bit easier for me. Ah, shit. I landed on the coop. That was really good, too. Ah, shit. You bad, Johns? Bruh. But it's not Johns, though. How could it be P-Bad John's if it's not John's? I genuinely, it's not my fault. It's not my fault. How could it be P-Bad John's if it's not my fault? I can't do it! I can't do it! Oh, this one might be it. Oh, I got in and then I... F-
fucking blew it. Ah, I got to a new area and I didn't know what to do. All right, so we know kind of how that other area works now. But the textures in this game are kind of bad, but like, overall, this game is like really solid. Especially for what I assume was a somewhat small team of people. No! I feel like I was so close there. I'm not aiming down enough there. That's what I'm supposed to be doing. Just get like a lot of fucking lift. Good, this is good, this is somewhat good, please. I have to get in there on the left. Shit. Unless I get like a ton of lift, which I think is very improbable. Also, shout out to the Buffalo Chicken Mac and Cheese. Sorry, Lambert. When we were at the fucking Butter Nance wedding, you weren't there. You were there, but you weren't like with us when we went to get the fucking Buffalo chicken mac and cheese. That shit was the definition of lit. Oh, I was doing so good that time. Ooh, doing really good. Oh, and then I fucking blew it. Come on, P. Yes. No. Yes. What is this? Oh, did I make it? Oh, bless it. Ooh. I thought I was gonna fuck up at the last second. What's this one? All right. Yeah, we'll go ahead and do this one another time. So we're about 45-ish% of the way through the game. Not bad. But realistically, as the game's getting harder, that basically means 20%. Anyways.